Good morning, children. Welcome to AIIMS India online classes, biology session, nature and scope of biology. So we have been discussing about the nature of biology, different branches of biology, and the different scientists and their contributions. Like that, we have discussed different aspects related to the nature of biology. In this video, we are going to discuss more about the nature of biology. That is, the biology is the science of exception, and about the scope of biology also we are going to see. Okay, children, are you ready? So let us proceed. Biology is a science of exceptions because every branch has its own exceptions. So biology is also having its it is an exceptionally an important branch of science. The exceptions are inherent in biology due to evolutionary divergence. Okay, the exceptions are inherent in biology due to evolutionary divergence. Not only living organisms, but viruses and biomolecules also exhibit exceptional forms. Here, what is biology actually according to the definition? Biology is the science of living organisms, study of living organisms. So, but viruses and these biomolecules, when some of the non-living aspects are also we are going to study. So that's why it is an exceptional forms. Biology exhibits the exceptional forms like viruses and biomolecules. A student of biology must be prepared to accept and enjoy this gesture of nature. A student of biology must be prepared to accept the and enjoy this gesture of nature. Nature having its own gesture. Gesture means shape. Okay? The position, posture, gestures, these are all. The nature also shows its gesture. So being a biology student, you must be prepared to accept that. Okay? Some exceptions have been explained logically, while for others the reasons are yet to be searched out, because some of the concepts and hypotheses, it must be explained logically. And actually the science is the search of truth. Science can be defined as the search of truth. So logically we have to accept some concepts and hypotheses, but we have to search for the reasons, and we have to search out the actual reason behind it. Okay, following are the noteworthy exceptions in zoology. So some exceptions are given. What are they? Let us see. First, mammals are usually terrestrial, fossorial or arboreal, but bat is only flying and whale and seals are aquatic mammals. Okay, so here mammals means the animals which directly give birth to their young ones and feed their young ones with milk. They are terrestrial. Terrestrial means which live on land. Fossorial. Fossorial means which live in the holes of the earth. Or arboreal. Arboreal means which live on trees. But bat is the only flying mammal. Okay. Eudynamous. Bat. So generally the animals which have wings, they are considered as birds, like that in an opinion. But bat also possess the wings, that is a patagium. The wing of bat is an extension of a skin. The four limbs are modified into wings in the bat, and so it is a flying mammal. And whales and seals. Blue whale, the largest animal. So it is a mammal, which is aquatic. Seal, an aquatic. Okay. So some exceptions are there. So mature mammalian RBCs are devoid of nucleus except camel. So generally, the mammalian RBC, when it is premature, means not mature or early RBC, it consists of nucleus. But when it gets mature, that RBC is considered as a prokaryotic cell, because nucleus and other organelles will disappear. But in camel's blood, the RBC are nucleated. Nucleated RBC are present in the camel and lamba. Okay. So this is an exception. Next, the aquatic stage of some salamanders. Salamanders are amphibians which live on land and in water. Okay. Some salamanders like Embystoma is able to reproduce, pedogenesis, and attain sexual maturity. Means Embystoma larva itself gets the ability to reproduce. That is called pedogenesis. And it attains sexual maturity. So it is called, the phenomenon is called neoteny. Neoteny. So you will study in higher classes. The total neoteny is found in Nectarus, Siren, and Proteus. Proteus is also an amphibian, which is a blind amphibian, okay, which dwells in the caves. Okay. So aquatic larval stage of some salamanders like Embystoma is able to reproduce. So reproducing at larval stage is pedogenesis, and attains the sexual maturity at the larval stage. It is called as neoteny, and the total neoteny is found in some species like Nectarus, Siren, and Proteus. These are all amphibians. Next, heart is three-chambered in reptiles, but four-chambered heart is present in the crocodiles. So ventricle is partially divided in the crocodile. So it is an exception. So it is two-chambered heart present in the fishes, but there are three-chambered heart present in certain fishes like Protopterus. It is also called a lung fish. Protopterus, which possess lung-like structures. Instead of gills, the Protopterus is possessing lungs as a respiratory organ. That's why they are called lung fishes. Okay. Next, it is also an exception. Because what is an exception means, so a special feature. Okay, generally all of the remaining organisms possess one characteristic feature, and one single organism in that group may possess a different characteristic feature. So that is called exceptional, okay, or unique feature. Biology is the science of exceptions. Under that, zoology part we are discussing means about the animals. The DNA is double-stranded in all cells, and DNA viruses but single-stranded in bacteriophage virus. Okay, DNA is double-stranded in all cells, and DNA viruses but single-stranded DNA is present in the bacteriophage. In the same manner, RNA is a single strand generally in all cells, and RNA viruses but double-stranded reovirus, rice dwarf virus, and wound tumor virus. Okay, these viruses possess a double-stranded RNA. Okay, So this coronavirus also single-stranded RNA virus it is. HIV virus, RNA virus. Okay. Science and technology. Discovery of radioactive isotopes enabled tracing metabolic pathways, the development of microscope and then electron microscope provided useful tools to study biology. Science and technology are combined. They cannot stay isolated. They will go with each other, these two branches, science and technology. Technology, adopting technology in studying the science helped in deep study. For example, the discovery of electron microscope by Knoll and Ruska. Okay, it changed the scenario of cell science. Okay, so that's why the different technologies like radioactive isotopes, chromatography technology, discovery of electron microscope, these are all provided the strength to the study of biology, okay, living organisms. X-ray crystallography. X-ray crystallography is one of the important invention. It helped the study of the structure of DNA. Without that, the DNA structure was a puzzle. Okay. So, X-ray crystallography helped in the study of the structure of DNA, structure of protein, and many other biomolecules. Okay. What are biomolecules? The biomolecules are nothing but carbohydrates, proteins, fats, amino acids. The proteins means amino acids, fatty acids means fats. Okay, and RNA, DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid, ribonucleic acid. These are all biomolecules. Okay, next, science and technology. Biotechnology and genetic engineering, these two are the most advanced branches of the applied biology. Okay, biotechnology and genetics, genetic engineering, these two are the combination of different branches of biology. Okay, they are fruitful due to accumulation of knowledge from different sources. It is noteworthy that while information gathered from the basic researches enriched the field of applied researches. So what I told them, applied branches they are. So without biotechnology and genetic engineering, now no medicine may be synthesized. Okay. So without biotechnology and genetic engineering, no hybrids, varieties, no advanced treatment of diseases is possible without these two technologies. Okay. So they are applied. It is noteworthy that while information gathered from the basic researches enriched the field of applied researches, the fruits of applied researches contribute to explore and widen the area of basic researches. Inventions of new technology extended new hopes and open avenues for the work and research which was not possible earlier. Okay, what is that major institute? CSIR. Okay, Central Scientific Industrial Research. It is located at New Delhi. So from where so many scientists come out, the knowledge of the scientists flourished there, sharpened there by using the different modern equipment required for the research are there. Okay, so inventions of new technology extend new hopes and open avenues for the work and research which was not possible earlier. It is possible only because of the introduction of technology in the study of science. Okay. Next, scope of biology. So there is a vast scope, the biology. Biology creates an awareness of vast array of forms of life which normally goes unseen. Biology offers a large scope and provides a large field for study. Okay? The scope of biology is unlimited. Some important fields given here. Biology helps us to understand ourselves better. Biology helps us to understand ourselves better. It unfolds different queries of life. Different queries of life along with its cultural, social, physiological, and economical aspects. Finally, it helps in understanding the life better. Isn't it? Biology and interrelationship of living beings. It's every living organism, particularly every human being, is a biologist. Our day starts with biology, ends with biology. Okay? So biology and interrelationships of living beings, biology and resources. Next, biology and literature. Okay, so these are all, we can't isolate the biology from our day-to-day life. Without biology, nothing is done. So every day, so this biology plays an important role. Literature means, the literature means in writing some articles like that related to biology. Okay? So for example, biology and interrelation of living beings. The study of biology helps us in understanding the wonderful phenomenons and the laws of nature, which finally tell us to predict the behavior of different living beings under changed conditions. Isn't it? Biology and resources previously. How the biology and relation to resources? Biology helps us to know how to tap and conserve the resources available to us. For example, birds, fishes, forest, conservation of different animals, okay, different projects introduced. Next, biology and literature. So biology of natural biology, the knowledge of natural biology has greatly enriched the literature and their references in stories and poems. The poets and other authors have been inspired by the beautiful and interesting plants and animals and frequently figure them in stories, poems and drama. Okay? The study of nature is a rewarding experience. The many plants, okay, like marigold, roses, different types, dahlia, asters, etc., are used for ornamental purposes. The variety available in animals is widely enjoyed in zoological parks. Isn't it, children? The students enjoy excursions whenever you go to picnics, educational tours, we can say, excursions to remote place, to the remote areas, watching never seen before plants and animals. Okay, botanical gardens where certain rare species of plants can be grown. Okay, some medicinal plants So that's why you have to participate in the excursions or educational tours. Okay, biology in solving the problems. Biology makes us to understand the present day problems. For example, population growth, population growth, and the pollution, conservation of wildlife, and even the survival of man also. The future directions of biotechnology, the conservation of biodiversity, maintenance of environment, and human welfare remain in the hands of a biologist. So biology knowledge helps in solving so many problems. Biology in medical aspects. So it's one of the most important. So there are several plant species are there in the Ayurveda. For example, the several plants like Atropa belladonna, Cinchona officinalis. These are the sources of atropine and quinine, which are useful in the treatment of cancer and which are useful in the treatment of malaria. Okay, many members of the fungi. So for what we call the antibiotics, Penicillium notatum, Streptomyces, penicillin, streptomycin, the antibiotics. Okay, they are produced from the fungi. The plants are the major source of even vitamins. Drugs are first tested on animals before being used for the treatment of human. The animals provide the scientific hints for the production and use of medicines. The animals are widely used for scientific research, and results thus obtained are finally applied to man, isn't it? The study of animal play an important role in health, nutrition, and control of pests. Many diseases like malaria are caused and transmitted by the different mosquitoes. Okay, so the scientists, before releasing any medicine, say ICMR, okay, Indian Council of Medical Research, NIV, National Institute of Virology, say these laboratories national wide, they will do the research, and testing trials will be there. Based on the results of the testing trials, they will introduce the new vaccines. That's the reason why the vaccine for coronavirus is becoming delay, because still testing trials are going on. Okay, solving approach of biology. Solving approach of biology. The knowledge for the eradication of diseases like malaria, smallpox have been achieved by scientists basically due to desire and determination to solve the problem. So scientists, they will sacrifice their personal life. They will always think about the welfare of the society. Okay, so day and night, so irrespective of the time, they possess a strong desire and determination to solve the problem. Next, ecosystem and living organisms. Biology helps us in understanding the various ecosystems. The living community and non-living environment interact with each other, and exchange of materials in the ecosystem takes place. Okay, what is the ecosystem? Ecosystem can be defined as the structural and functional unit of biosphere. Okay, next, biotechnology. So this is the last in the scope of biology. Biotechnology, biotechnologists have produced many genetically modified GM crops. The plenty of studies are being made by geneticists who study about the genetics, evolutionists, and cytologists to fudge the efficacy of biotechnology. Okay, biotechnology is the combination of cell biology, molecular biology, genetics. So new species before introducing, so many tests have been done. Whether that will resist the particular environment, it can able to survive or not, that is called quarantine tests. They are called quarantine tests. Okay, children. Thank you for watching our video. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to receive latest updates.